हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज पीसीआर। व्हाट इज अ लॉन्ग फॉर्म ऑफ पीसीआर? एस, इट इज अ पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शंस, पॉलीमरेज चेन रिएक्शन। पॉलीमरेज, इट इज अ डीएनए पॉलीमरेज and it causes extension of nucleotides in a DNA synthesis. So it is responsible for DNA synthesis. The main function is to add nucleotide to the existing nucleotide primer. It is the role of DNA polymerase. And what is the meaning of chain reaction? It is a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction which sits in exponential manner, which proceeds in exponential manner to produce desired product. Okay, now what is definition of PCR? It is a amplification technique. PCR is a cell-free amplification technique to produce several copies of DNA. It is a cell-free amplification technique to produce several copies of DNA. Now coming to the requirements of this PCR. Requirement for this PCR, you need one temperature regulating machine that is known as PCR machine. It is a thermal cycler. Also known as PCR machine. Then second requirement is template DNA. What is the meaning of template DNA? It is a strand of DNA which act as a template for synthesis of new strand. It is a strand of DNA. It is a segment of DNA molecule. Segment of DNA required for synthesis of new DNA molecule, which is known as template DNA strands. Okay, third requirement is primers, also known as oligonucleotide primers of length of, it has length of 20 to 30 nucleotides, and these primers are complementary. These are complementary to the ends of target DNA, to the ends of target DNA to be amplified. This is, suppose this is a target DNA, these primers is of 20 to 30 nucleotide in length and they are complementary to the ends of this target DNA. And they provides or they help in starting of extension or they help in DNA synthesis. DNA polymerase cannot initiate its nucleotide synthesis at its own. It requires a short stretch of molecule which is provided in the form of primers or oligonucleotide probes or synthetic oligonucleotide probes. These probes are of two types. They are forward and reverse primers. They are required for the DNA polymerase to act. Okay, so fourth requirement is TAC DNA polymerase. दिस पॉलीमरेज इट इज फ्रॉम द बैसिलस थर्मस एक्वेटिकस, इट इज फ्रॉम द बैसिलस थर्मस एक्वेटिकस. ओके, इट इज फाउंड इन हॉट स्प्रिंग एंड कैन विदस्टैंड द इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर अप टू 90-95 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. सो दिस इज यूजफुल इन द PCR रिएक्शन. टैक DNA पॉलीमरेज ऑब्टेंड फ्रॉम थर्मस एक्वेटिकस. वॉट इज द रोल ऑफ DNA पॉलीमरेज? DNA पॉलीमरेज कैन एक्सटेंड द न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स. ओके, इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सिंथेसिस ऑफ न्यू DNA over a template DNA by using oligonucleotide probes. It also has exonuclease activity. Okay, and the fifth requirement is deoxynucleotide triphosphate, DNTPs. They are required. Four types of DNTPs are there: the deoxy ATP, deoxy guanosine triphosphate, then deoxy cytidine triphosphate and deoxythymidine triphosphate. These nucleotides are required for the PCR. So thermal cycler, it is responsible for temperature regulation, and there are tubes in this thermal cycler. These tubes, they contain reaction mixtures, they contain template DNA strand, they contain primers, they contain tagged DNA polymerase and deoxynucleotide triphosphates. These all substances, these all molecules, they are provided in a tube in a thermal cycler. Okay, now the steps in PCR. Three basic steps, they are involved in the PCR technique. It is a molecular Xerox machine, means from one copy you will get multiple copies, as in Xerox machine. Okay, so steps includes, the first step is denaturation. What is the meaning of denaturation? It is a separation of two strand of DNA when we heat the solution. Denaturation, it is at 95 degree centigrade. It requires 15 seconds to 2 minutes. Okay, we'll discuss this in diagram also. Second one is, the second step is the annealing or renaturation. Annealing, it is at 56 degree centigrade. It requires 30 seconds to 2 minutes. And third step is the extension or synthesis, extension of DNA molecule, which occurs at 72 degree centigrade. It requires about 30 minutes to 30 seconds to 2 minutes. Okay, so overall, for one step of PCR cycle, we need 3 to 5 minutes. And for 25 to 30 cycles, we required 3 to 6 hours. Okay. So these are the three basic steps in PCR process. First one is the denaturation, means separation of two strands of DNA. Then annealing, means synthetic oligonucleotide probes get attached to the end of target DNA sequence, that is known as annealing or renaturation. Okay, which occurs at 56 degree centigrade by lowering the temperature. Then again we increase the temperature up to 72 degree centigrade for extension or synthesis of DNA molecule over a segment of DNA by using oligonucleotide probes. This is the extension. Now we'll look this in the diagram. Denaturation, annealing and extension, it is done in a thermal cycler, PCR machine or thermal cycler. Now if this is a target DNA sequence, by denaturation एट 95 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड दिस टू स्ट्रैंड विल सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईच अदर. दिस टू स्ट्रैंड विल सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईच अदर. देन एनिलिंग प्राइमर्स आर एडेड. टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्राइमर्स आर देयर, फॉरवर्ड प्राइमर्स एंड रिवर्स प्राइमर्स. ओके, सो दीज प्राइमर्स आर एडेड इन द रिएक्शन ट्यूब. दिस इज ए वन स्ट्रैंड एंड दिस इज ए सेकंड स्ट्रैंड. ओके, नाउ दिस प्राइमर विल गेट अटैच्ड टू द एंड ऑफ दिस डीएनए, सेपरेटेड डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल. दीज आर द न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स. ओके, दिस इज दिस स्टेप इज नोन एज एनिलिंग. इट ऑकर्स एट 56 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. ओके, दिस इज फर्स्ट रिएक्शन डिनेचुरेशन, दिस इज सेकंड. नाउ इन थर्ड रिएक्शन व्हाट ऑकर्स, वी ऐड डीएनए पॉलीमरेज, टैक डीएनए पॉलीमरेज. इट इज एडेड, इट कॉजेस एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दिस ऑलिगोन्यूक्लियोटाइड प्रोब. इट कॉजेस एक्सटेंशन ऑफ ऑलिगोन्यूक्लियोटाइड प्रोब. दीज आर द प्राइमर्स. ओके, दीज आर द प्राइमर्स. एनिलिंग ऑकर्स एंड नाउ सिंथेसिस विल ऑकर इन 5' to 3' डायरेक्शन बाय द डीएनए पॉलीमरेज. दिस इज अ डीएनए पॉलीमरेज. इट कॉजेस एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दिस प्राइमर्स एंड सिंथेसिस ऑफ न्यू डीएनए विल ऑकर ऑन द एग्जिस्टिंग सेगमेंट ऑफ डीएनए. ओके, नाउ फ्रॉम वन डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल यू विल गेट टू डीएनए और फॉल फ्रॉम वन सेगमेंट. दिस इज टू स्ट्रैंड. फ्रॉम टू स्ट्रैंड ऑफ डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल यू विल गेट फोर स्ट्रैंड ऑफ डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल. नाउ अगेन दिस इज एट 72 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड नाउ स्टेप्स रिपीटेड. स्टेप 1, 2, and 3 रिपीटेड अगेन एंड अगेन टू प्रोड्यूस multiple copies, to produce millions of DNA molecule. Okay, and approximately 25 to 30 cycles are needed to produce 1 million, to produce 1 million copies of DNA molecule. Approximately 32 cycles are needed to produce 1 million DNA molecules. Okay, so this is a conventional PCR technique which is used in different biochemical processes or different recombinant DNA technology processes or recombinant DNA technology or molecular biology. Okay, now how it is useful in detection of various infection, how it is useful. Okay, so this is the basic, these are the basic steps in PCR process, that is denaturation, annealing and extension, also known as denaturation, renaturation and synthesis. These are the basic steps in the PCR process. Okay, now this PCR, what are the application, what are the different uses of PCR? First important use of PCR is, it is used for detection of viral infection. Now this term is, this term RT-PCR, it is in use because of COVID-19. Okay, we'll see that how it is useful in the detection of COVID-19 infection. It is used for detection of viral infections, HIV, then SARS-CoV-2, then it is also useful for detection of tuberculosis, that is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then third, it is used for detection of various cancers as ह्यूमन पेपिलोमा वायरस कॉजेज सर्वाइकल कैंसर, सो इट इज यूजफुल इन द डिटेक्शन ऑफ वेरियस कैंसर्स. देन फोर्थ, इट इज यूजफुल इन द प्रीनेटल डायग्नोसिस. फॉर दैट CVS, कोरियानिक विलस सैंपल इज टेकन, और सैंपल फ्रॉम एमनियोसेंटेसिस इज टेकन एंड PCR इज डन. सो इट इज यूजफुल फॉर डायग्नोसिस ऑफ वेरियस डिसीजेस, सिकल सेल डिसीज, थैलेसीमिया एंड वेरियस इनबॉर्न एरर्स ऑफ मेटाबोलिज्म कैन बी डायग्नोज विद द हेल्प ऑफ PCR टेक्निक. ओके, देन फिफ्थ, इट इज यूजफुल इन मॉलिकुलर बायोलॉजी और रिकॉम्बिनेंट DNA टेक्नोलॉजी. ओके, फॉर कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ जीन लाइब्रेरी. ओके, देन सिक्स, इट इज यूजफुल इन द फॉरेंसिक मेडिसिन. इट इज यूज फॉर आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ क्रिमिनल, थीव्स एंड रेपिस्ट. इट इज यूजफुल इन द पैटर्निटी डिस्प्यूट्स. ओके, सो इट इज यूज इन DNA फिंगरप्रिंटिंग. इट इज नोन एज DNA फिंगरप्रिंटिंग. ओके, these are the uses of PCR. Now, how it is useful in detection of viral infection, particularly COVID-19. COVID-19, it is a disease caused by the virus. The name is SARS-CoV-2. This is the virus. It is a RNA virus containing RNA as a genetic material, single-stranded RNA. As a genetic material. Okay, this is a SARS-CoV-2 responsible for COVID-19 disease. Okay, it is a pandemic now. COVID-19 is a pandemic now, and we heard about the PCR, RT-PCR technique, but how it is done? The throat swab or nasal swab is collected with the help of buds. Okay, collection stick. This is like how the swab is collected with the help of stick. Okay, it is like a earbud, similar to that of the earbud, but it is long enough to collect the swab. Nasal swab, oropharyngeal swab, throat swab is collected for this process, and it is, after collection, it is transported in the medium that is known as viral transport media, VTM. It is transported to the laboratory with the help of VTM. Okay, now when it reaches the laboratory, now what are the steps which are done in the laboratory for detection of this virus? So first step is the nucleic acid extraction, means RNA extraction. As it is a RNA virus, the first step is the extraction of RNA by various chemicals. Okay, there are various steps in the extraction process. We are not going in much detail of RNA extraction. The RNA extraction is done with the help of various chemicals. Then second step is, what is PCR? It is a amplification technique for DNA. Now what is this? This is RNA. What is this called as? Means synthesis of mRNA from DNA. It is known as, this process is known as transcription. Okay, this process is known as transcription. But synthesis of complementary DNA from this mRNA molecule, what is this known as? It is known as, this is complementary DNA, and this process is known as reverse transcription. Okay, so what is needed here? The reverse transcription is needed with the help of enzyme reverse transcription. And conversion of this RNA molecule into complementary DNA. Now this RNA, it is converted into complementary DNA by this process and with the help of enzyme reverse transcriptase. This is additional step in the detection of RNA virus in PCR. Now got this point? These RNAs, they are converted into complementary DNA molecule. Now conventional PCR is done, that is denaturation, renaturation and synthesis, or denaturation, annealing and extension is done, and number of copies of these viruses are produced, okay, by the PCR technique, by the step 1, 2, 3, that is denaturation, annealing and extension, multiple copies of this DNA produced. Okay, multiple copies, millions of copies are produced. And depending upon the cycles required, you can detect or you can comment on the viral load depending upon the cycles required to multiply, or depending upon the cycles required to get desired levels of DNA. You can tell or you can comment about the viral load. Okay, if less cycles are required, it means that viral load is much more in the patient. Okay, if less cycles are required to multiply. Okay, and if more cycles are required, means that means the viral load is less. How quantitative analysis is done on this PCR? Now in this COVID detection or SARS-CoV-2 detection, three technologies are useful. Three main PCR techniques they are used. That is known as RT-PCR. RT-PCR means reverse transcription PCR. Okay. Second, conventional PCR, it is used here. And third one is the real-time PCR. Real-time, it is also known as RT-PCR. So, RT-PCR, PCR and real-time PCR. These techniques are utilized here. What do you mean by real-time PCR now? Now, how will you quantify the viral load? How will you tell that? How will you analyze that person is infected from the COVID-19 or he is free from the COVID-19? So it is dependent on the real-time PCR. Real-time PCR tells about the quantitative analysis or real-time analysis. Quantitative analysis or real-time analysis of PCR technique. How it is done? In this Tacman probe, in this method, Tacman probe is used, or CyberGreen, Tacman probe, RSYBR Green. This dye or fluorescent dye is utilized to quantify the viral load. How it is utilized? When we are using the primer, along with primer, there is a need of probe, oligonucleotide probe, which is also get attached to the DNA sequence. This is a probe which get attached to the DNA sequence. Now in this probe, there is reporting dye or fluorescent dye, and one is the quencher dye. Quencher molecule is there. This is reporting dye and this is a quencher molecule. When they are in close proximity with each other, this will not report the fluorescence. When they are together, the reporter dye will not report the fluorescent. Okay, when they report the fluorescent, when they free from each other, when they are not in close proximity with each other, this dye will emit the fluorescent. Okay, now what happens in DNA synthesis? One, when the extension occur, this polymerase causes the extension, and polymerase has exonuclease activity. With this exonuclease activity, polymerase will remove these nucleotides one by one. So now this reporting dye, reporting fluorescent, this is a quencher molecule. They will be far from each other, and now this fluorescent will be emitted by this reporting dye. This fluorescent will be emitted by the reporting dye, which is connected with the instrument that is known as fluorometer. Fluorometer. It is detected by the fluorometer. एंड ईच स्टेप विद द इंक्रीज इन द डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल विद द इंक्रीज इन द स्ट्रैंड्स ऑफ द डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल दिस रिपोर्टर और दिस फ्लूरोसेंट डाई विल इंक्रीज. इफ फ्रॉम वन कॉपी देर इज सिंथेसिस ऑफ टू डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल दिस ऑल्सो डबल्ड. This report fluorescent will also double. So this is detected by the fluorometer and graphical display will be given on the monitor. Okay. Of this fluorometer, the graphical display will be given on the monitor. Okay. So it is like that. Okay. Now these are the initial cycles. This is the first cycle, second cycle, third, fourth, fifth, and then the exponential growth is there. This is the exponential growth and then plateau occurs. Okay. When it goes beyond the certain threshold, if this is a threshold, this is a baseline, when it goes beyond certain threshold, it is labeled as SARS CoV-2 positive, and when it is below that threshold, it is labeled as negative. Got it? This is RT-PCR, which is now in use for the detection of COVID-19. Got it? So this is about the PCR. It has lots of uses in the molecular biology, and this is the basic method which is required in the molecular biology. Got it? So this is how detection of CoV-2, SARS-CoV-2 is done. First reverse transcription, then PCR, and then PCR quantification by real-time PCR. I hope you understand the terminologies here. What do you mean by PCR? What are the steps of the PCR? What are the applications of PCR? What is the meaning of quantitative PCR or real-time PCR? How it is done? What is the meaning of fluorescent dye or fluorescent reporter? What is the use of quencher here? Then how it is interpreted, how interpretation is done, whether it is positive or negative. Okay, this is all about polymerase chain reaction. Keep watching. Thank you.